lambda equal to h by root of 2m into eb. These are the different formulas corresponding to de Broglie's wavelength. Next one, there is one note point. Suppose here, let us consider a particle charge on the particle is equal to q. Charge on the particle is equal to E is equal to Q. Starting from rest and also accelerated through a potential difference of V volts. Potential difference of V volts. Then you know the de Broglie wavelength lambda is equal to H by root of 2m into EV or 2m into QV, whatever it may be. Here, H is equal to Planck's constant. M is equal to mass of the particle. Small e is equal to charge on the particle. V is equal to potential difference. For example, first one. Let us take a proton. Electron. Mass of the electron is equal to Me. It is nearly 9.1 into 10 power minus 31 kilograms. Charge on the electron is equal to 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulombs. For electron. Next, for a proton, mass of the proton is equal to nearly 1836 times the mass of electron, and it is nearly 1.67 into 10 power minus 27 kilograms. Charge on the proton is equal to 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulombs. This is negative and this is positive for proton. Okay, na? So let us find out. See here, deuteron is equal to H12. There is one proton. Mass of the deuteron is equal to, mass of the proton. Charge on the deuteron is equal to 2 times the charge on electron. 2e. Next one, helium nucleus or alpha particle. Its mass is equal to 2 times the mass of proton. Charge is equal to 4 times the charge on electron. 4e. Remember these points. Let us consider a charged particle. Charge on the particle is equal to Q is equal to E. Charge on the particle Q is equal to E. This is accelerated through a potential difference of V volts. Accelerating potential difference V volts. So let the given particle is electron, say suppose. For electron. Find the de Broglie's wavelength entered. Lambda for electron is equal to, what is this value? In terms of potential difference, H by root of 2MeV. The value of H is equal to 6.62 into 10 power minus 34 joule second by root of 2 into mass of the electron is equal to 9.1 into 10 power minus 31 kilograms. Charge on electron is equal to 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulombs into V, where V is the potential difference. On solving it, it is root of 150 by V. Root of 150 by V, angstrom units. So, what is the formula for de Broglie wavelength corresponding to the electron? Root of 150 by V, where V is the potential difference to which the electron is accelerated. Nearly root of 150 means it is approximately 12.26 by root V angstrom units. This is the डी ब्रॉगली वेवलेंथ करेस्पॉन्डिंग टू द इलेक्ट्रॉन व्हाट इज इट रूट ऑफ 150 बाय वी आर 12.26 बाय रूट वी. नेक्स्ट सेकंड वन व्हाट इज द डी ब्रॉगली वेवलेंथ फॉर ए प्रोटॉन. फॉर ए प्रोटॉन लैम्डा फॉर प्रोटॉन इज इक्वल टू हियर आल्सो हेच बाय रूट ऑफ 2m इनटू ईवी. हेच इज इक्वल टू 6.62 इनटू 10 पावर माइनस 34 जूल सेकंड बाय रूट ऑफ 2 इनटू मास ऑफ द प्रोटॉन 1.67 इनटू 10 पावर माइनस 27 किलोग्राम्स इनटू चार्ज 1.6 इनटू 10 पावर माइनस 19 इनटू वी. वेयर वी इज द पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस ऑन सॉल्विंग इट nearly 0.082 by V or this is 0.286 by root V angstrom units. So what is the value of de Broglie wavelength of electron? 12.26 by root V angstrom units. For a proton 0.286 by root V. 0.286 by root V. Alani for and solving the similar way third one for a deuteron lambda is approximately equal to 0.202 by root v angstrom units. 0.202 by root v angstrom units. Next fourth one for an alpha particle. For an alpha particle, lambda is given by 0.101 by root V angstrom units. For alpha particle. Also, for a neutron, lambda is equal 0.286 by root capital E angstrom units. Where capital E is equal to total energy of the neutron. E is equal to ke of neutron which is represented in electron volts. So these are the different formulas for the de Broglie's wavelength corresponding to electron proton alpha particle, deuteron and also neutrons. Next one, suppose uncharged particles like a neutron. Uncharged particle, if it is a charged particle, then only it is accelerated through a potential difference. In case of neutral particles, they are not accelerated by the potential difference. So, in case of neutral particles, energy can be represented by, in equilibrium condition, energy capital E is equal to 3 by 2 kT, where K is equal to Boltzmann constant. This is equal to 1.38 into 10 power minus 23 joule per Kelvin. Boltzmann constant and T equal temperature, absolute temperature. So, for these neutral particles, lambda is equal to h by root of 3mkT. Ela, for general, lambda is equal to h by root of 2m into kinetic energy. That is equal to h by root of 2m into kinetic energy is equal to 3 by 2 into kT. 2 cancel. That's why 3mkT. Therefore, lambda is equal to h by root of 3m into kT. Let here, for neutron, in terms of absolute temperature, its de Broglie wavelength is equal to nearly 30.8 by root T angstrom units, where T is equal to absolute temperature. Next, one more application is there. Let's find our problem. Suppose a particle of mass m a particle of mass m projected horizontally with a velocity u. If it makes an angle theta with the horizontal after some time, then at that moment, what is the de Broglie wavelength? It is given. A particle of mass m is projected horizontally with a velocity u. Horizontally with a velocity u. So in case of horizontal projectile, this moves like a parabolic path. It is a parabolic path. After some time, its velocity is equal to v. Its velocity is equal to v. Also given, its velocity makes an angle theta with the horizontal. V will be resolved into two perpendicular components. This is v cos theta and vertical component is v sin theta. So in case of projectile, horizontal component of velocity remains constant, means u is equal to v cos theta. U is equal to v cos theta. From this, v is equal to u by cos theta. Therefore, corresponding de Broglie wavelength at that point lambda is equal to h by mv, or this is equal to h by m into v is replaced by u by cos theta. Therefore, lambda is equal to h into cos theta by mu. Lambda equal to h into cos theta by mu.